Welcome to this tutorial on leveraging ERA Commons to complete required grant closeout reports. The closeout feature in ERA Commons allows grantees to submit all closeout reports electronically. To help facilitate the timely completion of the closeout process, NIH has developed closeout features to provide simple ways for grantees to identify grants involved in the closeout process, to respond to NIH requests for materials, and to receive NIH e-notification updates about the closeout status of the award. By the end of this video, principal investigators and signing officials will have an understanding of how to use ERA Commons to A. initiate the closeout process, B. access required reports, C. respond to final report FRAM requests related to the final progress report. Additionally, grantees will learn about the potential consequences of not completing the closeout requirements in a timely manner. The Final Report Additional Materials, or FRAM, functions in the same manner as the Progress Report Additional Materials, PRAM. PRAM is a procedure used for the Research Performance Progress Report. FRAM has been implemented to improve consistency in NIH procedures and communications for following up with grantees to clarify or further explain information provided in the final progress report. It leverages the PRAM functionality used with the RPPR in anticipation that NIH will transition from the final progress report to the final RPPR as the closeout report for research and research-related grants. The closeout requirements are effective for all grants with a project end date on or after October 1, 2014. To access closeout, log into ERA Commons status screen. Signing officials will use the general search link, or for a quicker option, the closeout link. The closeout link will initiate a search for grants that are currently ready for closeout or are already closed. Included as part of the search option will be the Requires FRAM checkbox. This option can be used to filter the search results to just grants where additional materials have been requested by the awarding IC. Principal investigators will access their grants through the List of Applications Grants link from their status search screen. Regardless of the role, the Requires Closeout link appears in the Action column. By policy, all closeout reports and procedures should be completed in a timely manner after the project end date. The closeout process typically includes completing three reports. Final federal financial report. Completing this report requires the user have the FSR role. Final progress report. And final invention statement, if applicable for the type of award. In the action column for the final FFR, there'll be two options to select from. A. Create new. This link initiates the final federal financial report. B. View. This will be used if the report has already been initiated and needs to be reviewed and/or modified. To initiate the final progress report and the final invention statement, there'll be the Process Final Progress Report and the Process Final Invention Statement links, respectively, in the Action column. If a grant is in the process of being closed out and the awarding IC has initiated a FRAM request, the FRAM requested text will appear in the Status column, and FRAM update link will be in the Action column of the closeout search results. From this link, grantees will be able to upload, view, and submit the information as requested by the awarding IC. The specifics of the request will be sent to the email addresses of the signing official and the principal investigator. They can also access the FRAM information from the Other Relevant Documents section of the Detailed Status Information screen. As part of the NIH effort to improve visibility of the closeout process for grantees, notifications will be sent shortly after the grant end date. Two additional notices will be sent after the reporting deadline has passed if acceptable reports have not been submitted. Many grantee organizations have staff dedicated to managing the closeout of grants and the corresponding financial information. These folks do not have, nor do they need, an ERA Commons account. For them, a quick query tool allows them to use their organization's Institutional Profile Number, IPF, to search for projects with upcoming end dates and whether those grants have already received a no-cost extension and the due dates of required closeout reports. When all the required closeout reports have been completed, submitted, and accepted, the grantee institution will receive an email confirming the completion of the grant closeout process. This notice will include record retention information covered under administrative regulations. If an institution does not complete the closeout process in a timely manner, according to policy, NIH must execute a unilateral closeout of the award. While NIH will make several efforts to secure the required reports, the consequences of not complying with those requests can be, but are not limited to, removal of authorities, such as carryover and streamlined non-competing award process SNAP procedures, delay or withholding further funds, suspension or termination of other awards. This concludes this video tutorial on grant closeout procedures. In this tutorial, you have seen how to A. Initiate the closeout process. B. Access required reports. C. Respond to final additional materials FRAM requests. Additionally, the consequences for not completing the closeout process in a timely manner have been reviewed. For more information concerning the closeout process, please visit NIH's Grant Closeout page, as well as the Closeout FAQs page. Thank you for watching.